Good morning, 11th class. I hope you all are doing well, students. Student, as you know that I have covered the syllabus, our both books has been finished. We have done complete syllabus. So now I am taking one CBSE sample paper so that you can learn and you can start practicing. Those who has not finished their written work of both the books, they can complete it now and do submit it to me. Okay, so let's start with the sample paper. In this sample paper, as you have given in midterm also, there are two parts, section A, which is of introductory microeconomics, and section B, which is of statistics, and both the parts of 40 marks each. And marks for questions are generally indicated against each question. You know that question number 1 to 4 and question number 13 to 14 are very short answer questions and they are of 1 marks. And then 5, 6 and 15, 18, they are short answer questions carrying 3 marks. Then 7 to 9 and 19 to 20, these are of 4 marks. Then 10 to 12 and 21 to 23, they are of 6 marks each. Long questions are there. By now, this kind of pattern we are following in question paper. If pattern will change, I'll let you know. Even in that case, these questions will be important. Okay, so let's start with introductory microeconomics. Section A, question 1 is, at the break-even point for a firm, TR equals to TC, TR greater than TC, and TR less than TC, then this is TR equals to 0. So for this, correct answer is A part, which is TR equals to TC. Why this is correct answer? Because at break even point, we know that TR is equal to TC. Then second question, the demand curve of a firm would be horizontal straight line under perfect competition, monopoly, oligopoly, monopolistic competition. So answer for this is under perfect competition. Monopoly, oligopoly and monopolistic competition, these we have not done for this year specifically. Why we have not done? Because of this COVID-19, your 30% syllabus has been deleted. So we didn't cover it up. But some questions will come relating to that concept. So if we have covered even partially, then I'll take up the question. Okay. The demand curve of a firm would be horizontal straight line under perfect competition. Then next question is oligopoly. Though it has been deducted because of COVID-19, still I am telling you, just for the knowledge, you should know what is oligopoly. Oligopoly refers to a form of market in which there are only few giant firms against a large number of firms. And there is high degree of interdependence among the firms. These firms are having high degree of interdependence. Then answer 4, why does the Indian government believe in fixing the support price for crops? Give reasons. Why does the Indian government believe in fixing the support price for crops? Give reasons. So answer for this is, the Indian government believes in fixing the support price for crops because the prices of some crops fall below the certain level, which is not fair for the farmers to earn their livelihood. So for the social well-being and for the help of farmers, Indian government believes in fixing the support price for crops. Next question, question number 5. Because of fall in price of a commodity, the quantity demanded rises by 10%. The price elasticity of demand is given as -0.5. What is the percentage fall in the price of the commodity? So here, as we know, the formula that price elasticity of demand equals to percentage change in demand upon percentage change in price. So formula we know already. So the equation will become 0.5 minus 0.5 equals to 10 upon percentage change in price. So from here we can calculate percentage change in price, and percentage change in price will come 10 upon 0.5, so it will be 20, minus 20%. So we can say that price will fall by 20%. How much price will fall? Price will fall by 20%. Now question 6. State the differences between fixed cost and variable cost. State the differences between fixed cost and variable cost. So answer for this is fixed cost. First point, fixed cost refers to the cost which remain constant irrespective of the level of output. Fixed cost refers to the cost which remain constant irrespective of the level of output. Variable cost. Variable cost refers to the cost which vary with the level of output. Variable cost refers to the cost which vary with level of output. Second point in fixed cost, they are never zero. Even at zero level of output, fixed cost have to be incurred. Fixed cost are never zero. Even at zero level of output, fixed cost have to be incurred. Variable cost are zero at zero level of output. They rise with the rise in output and fall with the fall in level of output. That we have done. Like fixed cost is very much like rent. Like you have taken a building on rent. So whether you are producing or not producing any output, or whether you are producing 10 units of output or 20 units of output, the rent of that building will remain same. So that is fixed. Okay. And similar example is example of plant and machinery, and that is fixed cost. And example of variable cost is cost of raw material. Like if you are making 10 units, then you need less raw material. But if you are making 20 units, then you need more raw material. Okay. Now question number 7. What is meant by market demand? What is market demand curve? How is it derived from the individual demand curve? So answer for this is, market demand for a commodity refers to the total demand for the commodity by all the individual customers in the market. The market demand curve shows the different total quantities of the commodity which are demanded by all consumers in the market at different prices. So the market demand curve is derived from the individual demand curve by horizontally summing the various individual demand curves. Like we can sum up the demand curve of A, demand curve of B, and demand curve of C. If there are three firms A, B, C, we can do the sum of those market demand curves, and the resultant curve will be the market demand curve. Question number 8. With a 10% rise in the price commodity, the quantity supplied rises from 500 units to 550 units. Calculate the price elasticity of supply. So again, this question is of price elasticity of supply is there now. Earlier we did price elasticity of demand. So formula for price elasticity of supply equals to percentage change in quantity supplied divided by percentage change in supply. So if a percentage change, we will calculate here percentage change. How we will calculate? By deducting the 500 minus 550 minus 500 upon 500 multiply 100. By this way we can calculate the percentage change in quantity supplied. If we will do this calculation, it will come 10. So after calculating percentage change in quantity supplied, we are already given with the percentage change in price of a commodity. So now we can easily calculate price elasticity of supply. So price elasticity of supply will be 10 upon 10 equals to 1. So in this case, answer will be 1. Now next is production possibility curve. Production possibility curve is again like it has been deducted because of that COVID, but still I'm just giving the answer for knowledge purpose. You should know all these things because somehow it's going to be there in classes, like if you are studying eco at graduation level or in 12th, or not much in 12th, but at graduation level it might come again, so you should know the concept. So I'm just telling the answer for this PP curve. The production possibility curve refers to the curve which presents the alternative combinations of production possibilities of two goods which can be produced with the given resources and the given technology. The production possibility curve refers to the curve which represents the alternative combinations of production possibilities of two goods which can be produced with the given resources and the given technology. Now next is what is the slope of PPC? Again, this is from this topic only. What does it indicate? Why is PPC concave to the origin? So slope of production possibility curve is the marginal opportunity cost or the marginal rate of transformation. It indicates the units of one good which must be sacrificed for each additional unit of other good. Means slope of PPC is given by change in Y divided by change in X, and it's represented by delta Y upon delta X. And PPC curve is always concave to the origin because of a rising marginal rate of transformation. Or in other words, we can say the rising slope of PPC. As the number of units produced of one good rises, for each additional unit of good, greater units of other goods must be sacrificed. So in other words, we can say opportunity cost of producing the good rises. This gives rise to the concave shape of PPC. Now question number 10, with the help of a diagram, explain the impact of the following on the demand for a normal good. Rise in income of consumer or change in taste and preference away from the good. So students, these questions have curves also. So I'll explain this answer again in next video with the help of curve. Same question 11. 11 question is also having a curve. So the questions which are having curves, I will explain those questions with the help of curves in next video. Let's do questions which are of one mark. So for that we have come on section B, stats for economics. Question 1 is, statistical data is essential for formulating policies of economic development. Illustrate with an example. So answer for this is, government wants to formulate or modify labor laws, then government will require statistical data on working conditions, number of working hours and minimum wages received by workers. So this could be an example for formulating policies of economic development. Next is, if 8 If 8 workers earn the following income, 30, 36, 34, 20, 42, 46, 54, 62, then the arithmetic mean will be, so arithmetic mean formula over here is x bar equals to sigma x upon n. So we will do the sum of all these values, then divided by 8, as we are having 8 values. So arithmetic mean will be 40.5. This value is not given in the options. So we will calculate it and we will give that value which is coming. Okay, we will do rest of the questions in next video, as we need explanation and curves for all these questions.